हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गीता चुग. वेलकम टू माय चैनल लर्न इंग्लिश विद गीता मैम. सो टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द चैप्टर माय चाइल्डहुड. लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग. वन डे ही इनवाइटेड मी टू डाइन हिज होम फॉर अ मील. हियर कलाम इज टेलिंग अबाउट एन इनविटेशन मेड बाय हिज साइंस टीचर शिव सुब्रमण्य अय्यर. फाइन. हिज साइंस टीचर इनवाइटेड हिम टू हिज होम फॉर अ मील. हिज वाइफ वॉज horrified at the idea of a Muslim boy being invited to dine in her ritually pure kitchen. Ritually pure means kept protected from all outside influences. She was an Orthodox Brahmin lady. She was deeply rooted to her religion, and that's why she has kept her kitchen ritually pure. And to see a Muslim boy being invited to dinner, she was horrified. She felt horrified. Shiv Subramanya Iyer was not perturbed, but to see the behavior of his wife, this gentleman Shiv Subramanya Iyer did not get disturbed, okay, nor did he get angry with his wife, but instead served me with his own hands and sat down beside me to eat his meal. In spite of this, what did the gentleman do? He just सेट डाउन बिसाइड कलाम. कलाम के साथ में ही वो बैठ गए एंड स्टार्टेड टेकिंग हिज मील. हिज वाइफ वॉच्ड अस फ्रॉम बिहाइंड द किचन डोर. शी डिड नॉट कम नियर. आई वंडर्ड वेदर शी हैड ऑब्जर्व्ड एनी डिफरेंस इन द वे आई एट राइस, ड्रिंक वाटर और क्लीन द फ्लोर आफ्टर द मील. नाउ कलाम वॉज वंडर्ड दैट इफ शी कुड ऑब्जर्व एनी डिफरेंस इन द ईटिंग वेज और द वे दे ड्रिंक वाटर or the way they clean the floor after the meal. Means here Kalam want to say that he adopted the same ways which Mr. Subramanyam Iyer adopted. Fine. When I was leaving his house, Shiv Subramanya Iyer invited me to join him for dinner again the next weekend. See, once the lady was horrified to see the idea, and here his husband Mr. Iyer is giving an invitation, one more invitation to come his home again for dinner the next weekend. Observing my hesitation, he told me not to get upset. Now Kalam felt hesitated, but his teacher told him not to get upset. He said that once you decide to change the system, such problems have to be confronted. This is a very important statement from exam point of view. The statement is made by Mr. Shiv Subramanya Iyer. It can be asked to you. Fine. It is an important part. So when I visited his teacher said that once when someone decides to change the system, he has to confront, he has to face such problems. When I visited his house the next week, Shiv Subramanya Iyer's wife took me inside her kitchen. So when he went to dine the next weekend, there was a complete change. The lady took him inside her kitchen and served me food with her own hands. Then the Second World War was over and India's freedom was imminent. Imminent means to come into effect. Okay? It was believed that now India is certainly going to avail the freedom. Fine. Indians will build their own India, declared Gandhiji. And Gandhiji made a statement on this moment that Indians will build their own India in their own way. Okay? The whole country was filled with an unprecedented optimism. Unprecedented means hota hai, never felt before. Fine. And optimism means a hope. So this statement filled everyone with a ray of hope. Fine. I asked my father for permission to leave Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramananthapuram. Here, Kalam says that he asked his father for permission as he wanted to leave Rameshwaram and go for study at the district headquarters in Ramananthapuram. Now, what does his father say? Let's read. Here you can see in this picture, the lady is serving both of them in her ritually pure kitchen. Fine. So when he asked to his father to leave Rameshwaram, his father says, he told me as if thinking aloud, Abul, I know you have to go away to grow. He says that he knew it, that Abul has to go out to, Abul had to go out to make his career, to move ahead. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? Just to make him understand the things, he says, he gives an example that the bird seagull fly across the sun, means miles and miles, but he does not have a permanent home without a nest, and he takes his flight alone. So his father wants to make his son understand that if Mr. Kalam, his son, has to go somewhere out, then he need not bother about the home or going alone somewhere. He should have the courage like the bird seagull has. Fine. Your children are not your children. Sorry, he quoted Khalil Gibran to my hesitant mother. Now, as the mothers are not ready to send their children out for studies, here Kalam's mother also felt hesitant. Fine. And his father tried to quote one statement made by Khalil Gibran to convince his mother. He says, the quote of Khalil Gibran says, your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. Longing means desire. Means everyone's life has its own desire. So, children are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They must go with the desires their life has from them. Fine? They come through you, but not from you. The godfather says that the children, no doubt they come through parents, but they come from the house of Lord. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, for they have their own thoughts. Now the concluding lines of the quote say, you may give them your love, means parents can give their love to the children. They can guide them, but they cannot just impose their thoughts on their children. Fine? Because the children have their own thoughts. They also learn something through their experiences. Okay? Through the things they face in their lives. So, here he tried to convince his mother. So this was all about My Childhood, which is written by APJ Abdul Kalam. And this chapter is an extract from Wings of Fire, an autobiography. Fine?